You're listening to Radio Lewes, where the music matters. Welcome back to The Rock Show. My name is Ben Fuller, and as I promised last week, this week's show is all guitar legends. Now, I know I'm going to generate a little bit of comment on this show, because some of you are going to feel that I've missed somebody out. So I'm going to get it out of the way right away. If you think I have missed somebody, bear in mind I've only got an hour, and I've picked guitarists that I love, as well as genuine giants. Send me a request. Tell me who you think I've missed. And if I get enough, I will do a second show just on your requests. You can find us on Twitter and Facebook, and I will even publish this show's email address with this show, so you can email me directly if you want to. Keep them clean, or I won't read them out. But we're going to start with a classic. It is Black Sabbath and Paranoid. The iconic Paranoid, and a guitar there, of course, of Tony Iommi. And there's a great quote from bassist Geezer Butler, because Paranoid was the first Black Sabbath single release, coming 6 months after their debut album was released. And this quote from Geezer Butler: "A lot of the Paranoid album was written around the time of our first album, Black Sabbath. We recorded the whole thing in about 2 or 3 days live in the studio. The song Paranoid was written as an afterthought. We basically needed a 3-minute filler for the album. Tony came up with the riff, I quickly did the lyrics, and Ozzy was reading them as he was singing." Well, Paranoid has been ranked number one on VH1's 40 Greatest Metal Songs, and in March 2005, Q Magazine placed it at number 11 in its list of 100 Greatest Guitar Tracks. I think it should have been higher myself. This whole show is going to be a difference, a mixture of sounds, and the next one is Gary Moore, and this one happened to be a personal favourite of our Neil Tideswell. This is Out in the Fields.
Out
track with some great guitar there, and a single by former Thin Lizzy band members Gary Moore and Phil Lynott, released in 1985. The song is about the troubles in Northern Ireland, but I do know why Neil liked it. Next is a great old classic. This is George Thorogood and the Destroyers, and the wonderful guitar riff of Bad to the Bone.
Wide wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up, said, "Leave this one alone." She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone, bad to the bone, bad to the bone, bad, 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 bad to the bone. I broke 1,000 hearts. Before I met you, I'll break 1,000 more, baby, before I am through. I wanna be yours, pretty baby, yours and yours alone. I'm here to tell you, honey, that I'm bad to the bone, bad to the bone, bad to the bone. Woman beg, and I make a good woman steal. I make an old woman blush, and I make a young girl squeal. I wanna be yours, pretty baby, yours and yours alone. I'm here to tell you, honey, that I'm bad to the bone. Bad, 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 bad to the bone. We'll be right back.
from the album of the same name there, Bad of the Bone, George Thorogood. Not widely popular during its initial release. Originally released in September 1982. Recurrent appearances on MTV, which had only been created the year before, if you can believe that. And licensing for films, television and commercials has since made it very popular indeed. It's a fantastic tune with great guitars from George Thorogood and a wonderful saxophone solo there from Hank Carter, although that is sort of going off-piste slightly. Another truly legendary guitarist next. I've played his music several times on this show. This is Jeff Healey. This is River of No Return. From 1988 and his debut album, See the Light. The wonderful Jeff Healey there. The album was released on September 13th, 1988, and it was number 50 of the top 100 albums in Canada in 1989. I don't play nearly enough of his music, I don't think. I really should play more. The fact that he was completely blind didn't detract from the fact that he really was a true guitar legend. Next, we've got the only lady on today's list. That doesn't detract from the fact she's a fantastic guitarist. This is Lita Ford and Dancing on the Edge. Mm-hmm. Again, the title of the album there from Leda Ford. Born September 1958. She's an English-born American rock guitarist, actress, vocalist, songwriter, you name it. She was a lead guitarist with the Runaways in the late 70s, before embarking on a solo career in the 80s, which lasted until 1995. And then she took a bit of a hiatus, quite a long hiatus, in fact, 11 years, and returned to the stage in 2008, and she is still rocking, and I think she's an amazing guitarist. Next up, we got Michael Schenker, and are you ready to rock? Michael Schenker group there, and are you ready to rock? I know this sounds more about me than Michael Schenker, but I do think they should have thought harder about the name. There's nothing wrong with being proud, but it's quite often abbreviated to MSG, which always makes me think of artificial preservatives and monosodium glutamate. But Michael Schenker, the German rock guitarist, best known for his tenure in UFO as lead guitar, as well as his solo project. He was also an early member of Scorpions. Next, and this is on here because very few people play bass as lead guitar, but Lemmy did it wonderfully. This is Motorhead and Dead Men Tell No Tales.
This
Oh, fantastic. From Motorhead, from the third studio album, Bomber. And not only was Lemmy on bass, he also had Fast Eddie Clark on guitar. It is a fantastic, fantastic track. You're listening to Radio Lewes, where the music matters. This is the Rock Show Guitar Legends Special. And as I said earlier on, I only have an hour, so I can't get everybody in. If I've missed anyone, get in contact. And if you give me enough requests, I'll do another show based purely on your requests. I'll even publish the Rock Show's email address with this show. I seem to have skipped a track. I'm going to make up for that now. And this one was requested, actually, by our own Steve Parsons. This is Jeff Beck and Guitar Shop.
Cabs. You're a strat cat. Patch in. Dangerous distortion. Serious sustain. Slinky, super slinky. Boomers, double ball ends. It'll phase, it'll flange, it'll fuzz. It's fast, it's flexible. Just feel those frets. A simulated comb filter for stereoizing a mono source. It's got a scaled down strat style body with the feel of a Les Paul. Deep cutaways, no pickguard, and a couple of chrome buffers. Full shred. Stiff neck, brass nothing, and ebony fingerboard. Balls deluxe.
What an amazing showcase for Jeff Beck and his amazing guitar. Another absolute legend now, Jimmy Page with Led Zeppelin. This is Immigrant Song. Led Zeppelin, what an amazing tune. It is built upon a repeating riff and features lyrical references to Norse mythology. Of course, with Robert Plant's howling vocals, mentioning war-making and Valhalla. Now, I don't often play Queen on the rock show, but this one's got such a fantastic guitar riff from Brian May. This is Killer Queen.
She keeps a Moët Chandon in a pretty cabinet. Anthony Cake, she says, just like Marie Antoinette. A building remedy for Khrushchev and Kennedy. At a time, an invitation you can't decline. Caviar and cigarettes, well versed in etiquette. Extraordinarily nice. She's a killer queen, gunpowder, gelatine. Beam. Guaranteed to blow your mind. Recommended at the price. Insatiable and appetite. Wanna try? To avoid complications, she never kept the same address. In conversation, she spoke just like a baroness. Middleman from China. She might have been again, incidentally, in that way. Perfume came naturally from Paris. Naturally. Forgot she couldn't care less, fastidious and precise. She's a killer queen, gunpowder, gelatine, dynamite with a laser beam. Guaranteed to blow your mind. momentarily out of action, temporarily out of
class, you absolutely drive.
Now, this is embarrassing. My computer has just crashed with my script on it. So I haven't got the information to hand that I was going to give you. And besides, we're into the very last section of the show, and I want to get a lot more of this music in. So I'm just going to say what a fantastic track that was. And I will tell you that Brian May was actually sick through most of the recording for that album, but he did come back into the studio just in time to put that fantastic riff into that song. Next, I've got a Sharks track for you. Now, this is because of friend of the station and legendary guitarist Chris Spedding. Originally, I was going to use his own version of this song from his album Guitar Graffiti, but it's got a bit of a reggae feel to it, and I didn't think it would fit properly. So I've gone for Sharks. Music Breakout.
It sounds so fine on a guitar string. I think there's a song here to bring us all in.
our fantastic tune from the 2016 album Killers of the Deep, and Chris Spedding there on guitar. Trying to list all the people that Spedding has worked with over the years, it gives me a bit of a headache, but I will give you a short list. The Battered Ornaments, Frank Riccotti Quartet, King Mob, Mike Batten Friends, Nucleus, Ricky Norton, Sharks, Trigger, The Wombles, of course, not to mention countless others, which, like I say, is going to give me a headache. So I just want to say he is a fantastic guitarist, one of the best this country's ever produced. The shame is most people don't know his name. Everybody knows this guy's name. This is Jimi Hendrix.
Thank you.
plays nearly entirely guitar. What a fantastic tune. Originally appeared on their debut album, Are You Experienced? But was later later issued as their third single in the US as an alternative version, which appeared in the movie Wayne's World to great effect. Next, a modern guitar legend. This is Slash with his own solo project. This is Automatic Overdrive. Vocals of Miles Kennedy there. That was Slash. Now I'm at the end of the show. I am going to run over because I want to get this last one in. But I just want to say you've been listening to Radio Lewes, where the music matters. This has been the Rock Show's Guitar Legends. My name's Ben Fuller. And if you do think I've missed somebody out, get in contact. You can find us on Twitter and Facebook. You can leave a comment on the website. And I'm publishing the Rock Show's email address with this show, so get in contact with me personally. Send me your requests and I'll do another show just based on those requests, but keep them clean or I will not read them out. Thank you so much for listening. I'm going to leave you now with Steppenwolf and Born to be Wild.
attention in whatever comes our way. Yeah, darling, go make it happen. Take the world in a loving place. Fire all of the guns and bombs and explode into space. I like smoking lightning. Heavy metal thunder. Racing with the wind. And the feeling that I'm under. Yeah, I gotta go make it happen. Explode into space.